All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Garrett Ainsworth. He is the CEO of District Metals. And Garrett, it's good to see you again. How are you?
I'm doing great, Steve. Yeah, good to see you too.
Yeah, lots of updates to happen from the company. Let's begin with your most current news release, because it was a significant one that you've signed a definitive agreement with Boliden Minerals. And then this is a pretty big company. So let's take a step back and tell me how you got to this point.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's been a 13-month process. We initiated talks with Boliden, which is a $9 billion market cap company, in October of last year. And, with the idea to, fund exploration at Tomtebo, without diluting. It's been very difficult markets, obviously to raise capital, especially for base metal projects. Boliden is like the leading, mining company and smelting company within Scandinavia. So the agreement that we've reached with Boliden is that they're going to spend $10 million over 4 years, but it can go quicker on our Tomtebo project and on their Stollberg project that they're bringing in. And Stollberg is an amazing property. It's their top exploration project that has many similar characteristics to Garpenberg. It's more advanced than our Tomtebo project. And so we'll be earning in 15% on their Stollberg project, and they'll be earning in 85% on our Tomtebo project.
So obviously this is significant as far as moving Tomtebo forward, because that's a lot of exploration dollars that you're going to put in the ground right away. Let's update everyone where you're at with Tomtebo and what the next plan is for exploration.
Yeah, that's good. So we've focused a lot of our exploration, almost all of our drilling around the historic Tomtebo mine. Now that we've entered in this transaction with Boliden, we'll be able to explore all over the Tomtebo project. And that is something we discussed that we'd like to do. We've got the Lovas mine up in the northeast end of the property. That's about 12 or 14 kilometers away. And we'll be looking to put drill holes outside. So, our last drill program at the historic Tomtebo mine at the Steffenberg zone returned 25.5 meters of 8.2% zinc equivalent. It also contained a 0.4 meter interval with 84 grams per ton gold and 800 grams per ton silver. So bonanza grade gold right on the outside of the mass of sulfides. That's wide open at depth. That's obviously going to be one of our first drill holes when we initiate drilling at the historic Tomtebo mine. And we'll look to start that early next year, hopefully even January of 2024.
Yeah. Garrett, you mentioned that markets have been tough, and they have indeed, but now you've got a really strong player that you're with that obviously has the capital that you need to sort of move these things forward. And your interest in the Stollberg property as well really is a benefit for what's going on at District Metal. So it sounds like even with those tough market times, the company is right now well-funded and will be well-funded in the future.
Correct. Yeah, this means we can be quite aggressive with our exploration at Tomtebo and at Stollberg. These two properties are 35 kilometers apart along a very robust metallogenic belt, all in proximity to the historic Falun mine and also Boliden's Garpenberg mine as well. We've got some very exciting targets that we've been wanting to test for quite some time, and now we've got the funds to do it.
Well, congratulations on that. Very excited to see what's going to happen in the drilling next year. And very good that this was put together, and exciting times for you and the company ahead.
Excellent. Thanks very much, Steve. Yep. Good chatting again.
All right. There's Garrett Ainsworth, the CEO of the very busy District Metals.